Hello and welcome to the channel. In today's video, we're going to look at the economics of composting, both at a micro level and at a macro level. All right, let's get started. All right, first things first, starting this video, I want to mention a couple things. First of all is why I do believe that it is important to analyze composting in economic terms. The reason why I believe that analysis is really relevant is that at this point, in at least in Western societies, most people will believe that they have enough information in order to form a decision on whether they want to be engaged in the practice of composting or whether it is not worth their time. But most of the information is framed either on a sort of botanical lens or agricultural lens, essentially listing all the benefits of compost and what you can accomplish with it. Or it can be framed in kind of an environmental terms, in a sense that this is a thing that you should be doing because that's how you take care of the planet, right? And I believe both of these approaches are very true, and I 100% agree to it. But I do believe that in order to engage a conversation regarding policy making and essentially creating a framework for composting initiatives, you have to bring traditional economics into it. So that was the first thing. The second thing is essentially, what do I mean by traditional economics, right? Most of us know that economics is essentially the science of managing scarce resources, and those resources can be land, capital, or labor. But there's one thing I want to add to it, is that you have to consider time. And that's because of the principle or the analysis method of opportunity cost, right? We are people with virtually limitless possibility. And we could be doing so many different things with our time every second of every day. And in order to understand why should people be engaged in doing something, you have to understand why it is the most productive action that could be taken at that time. And this is what I want to bring into that analysis. Lastly, I also want to mention that most economic choices are trade-offs, in the sense that when you decide to do something with your time, you are essentially deciding to not do what you would be doing otherwise with your time. And every benefits and drawbacks of composting that I am going to be listing in this analysis have to be understood in those terms. All right, so now let's get into the actual analysis. Okay, first up in this analysis is the micro level, or household level, or individual level. I'm going to start with first a disclaimer, and that disclaimer is that I'm extremely sorry that it is sort of difficult for me to clearly enunciate a difference between the micro with the I and macro with the A. That's something that I've studied 7 years in the US. I'm originally French. And that's something that is just, I studied economics, and every time I had to talk about the microeconomics or microeconomics, I had to make sure people understood what I was saying. I don't know, it's like one of these, for many of you who learned a foreign language and speak it almost fluently, will know that there's like a couple words that you just cannot manage to pronounce correctly. And that's one of them. And I'm really sorry that I'm doing a video on economics right now, but bear with me. All right. Now that we have that out of the way, the micro with an I analysis. Well, essentially it's what composting can do for you as an individual in your apartment, in your house. First thing first, it will cut down on your fertilizer cost. And I realize that is not everybody's first concern, especially in economics terms, but this is the main reason why people get into it, is that they do not want to be buying chemical fertilizers anymore, especially if they have the resources they need readily available just because they cook, right? And the second reason is also tied to this, is that they want basically healthy plants, and they want to essentially be healthy while taking care of their plants, and that's why they tend to stay away from chemical fertilizers. That there's many ways to safely use chemical fertilizers, but there's no unsafe way to use compost, and that's essentially the reasoning behind it. But that's mostly apply if you have a garden. If you don't have a garden, you could be selling your compost, but that's something that deserves a whole new video, so I don't really want to mention that point in it, that element at this point. Right, third micro benefit of composting is that, and that's in my experience at least, when you start composting, you will essentially stop taking out your trash every day, and that's something that I think is really underrated. I don't know if you have roommates where you live, or if your family, if it's your role in your family to sort of take out the trash. I believe nobody really enjoys taking out the trash. When you start composting, you'll see that the trash doesn't feel as often. And fourth point, also the trash doesn't smell as bad. Because essentially everything that would make the trash smell bad will be taken out way more regularly. It won't have time to sort of like rot, and basically it makes handling waste and garbage a bit less like a chore, and kind of like, well, I have to do that, at least it doesn't smell bad. All right, the fifth point that I want to mention in this micro analysis is that and that's, I think at this point, is highly subjective, but I do believe that most people I've talked to have had the same experience. So I mentioned that it's subjective, maybe it is objective, I don't know. When you start getting into composting, you suddenly have a bigger reason to buy vegetables, buy fruits, buy fresh food, buy healthy food. Just because you actually do something with it, and you essentially you build something, you're achieving something with that waste, and you realize that buying pre-prepared meals and all this stuff, not a lot of that will go into your compost. And essentially, that was, at least for me, that was like one of the first reason that I switched to a healthier diet, is that I started composting and had something to do with essentially like the fruit peels, the vegetable peels, and all this stuff. I should mention at this point that I should go into the health benefits of fresh foods, but I'm sure you can find that sort of information through other channels. Right, so that was the five benefits of composting for you as an individual. Let's talk about two drawbacks that I could identify, but I'm not entirely sure they're valid. So I've mentioned that your like regular garbage or trash bin doesn't smell as bad as it used to. Maybe the way where you will collect the organic waste for the compost, maybe it will you may think that that's gonna smell. My experience, I've never, because I take out the compost every, it's almost every meal really, and I never noticed any smell really. It's just like I put in a little plastic box that has a lid on it that seals, and never had an issue with smell, but for some people maybe they will experience that. And then I've mentioned the time that you save because you don't have to take out the trash all the time anymore. Maybe you will lose more time sort of like going to your compost pile and throwing away the compost. And that's something that, for the sake of accuracy, I have to mention. I don't really believe it's a big drawback, but let's just put it out there that some people will find this aspect inconvenient. All right, so that was for the micro analysis. Now let's go into the macro analysis, which I believe will make a lot more sense, at least in traditional economic terms. All right, so first things first, I don't see enough composting being discussed in terms of recycling. But if you think about it, that's the most basic form of recycling, and that's the lowest cost form of recycling, composting is, because all you do is take your trash and put it in a pile. Well, there's ways to essentially speed up the composting process. I'm probably going to do a video on this as well, but it is the best way to recycle, because you need those nutrients that you sometimes believe it's waste. It's just something that you absolutely need in your daily life to grow food. Even if you're not the one growing food, like I mentioned before, if you we switch to the macro level, so we're talking about bigger composting initiatives, the recycled nutrients will be used by any communities, because anybody needs to eat. And maybe not every food production is done at a local scale, but even then, there is absolutely almost always a use for compost. Honestly, I'm gonna go on a limb and say there's always use for compost. Maybe you'll disagree, let me know in the comment section. Second thing is closely tied to the first point, is the concept of self-reliance and kind of like localizing development. And that's something that is really big, especially in terms of development studies. And that has been picking up steam in the last 10 to 15 years, is that we found out that economic development is done much more sustainably, and I mean that in economic terms, when it's done at a local scale. And if you rely on sort of like global supply chains for your economic initiatives, there's so much things that can go wrong. The price fluctuation, sort of like supply issues, sourcing issues. Self-reliance is just a sure way of making development happen. And composting enables that, because everybody eats and everybody needs food to be grown. So that's the two main aspects of what makes composting a great practice for self reliability and local reliability. Third thing that I want to mention is the reduction in waste management. So in most countries in the world, waste management is either fully financed or partly financed by public funds. But if you look at most of the successful composting initiatives, maybe they have had like a grant or a loan that has some sort of public resources in it, but it is mostly private initiatives. And I don't want to get into the debate of whether something is better if it's private or public. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that it doesn't cost money to compost, but it costs money to not compost. And that's a huge point for local government, for municipalities, for, depends on how the federal system is essentially in place in your country, but local governments should love composting, because it will save them money, because people will do something that they spend money for. And that's why it's beautiful. Fourth thing is employment opportunities. Compost can be a business. We'll talk a lot more about this in this channel, so please stay tuned, but just understand that it's a business that is doable in most societies. And you can create composting business that work, that generate revenue, and that require labor. It's not necessarily a labor intensive sort of business, but it does require labor, and that's how it creates a job. And people love, I mean, in policymaking, you love the concept of creating jobs. So that's something that you have to take into account. Lastly, and I believe, and many people will believe, that it is the main reason, and it's sort of weird to mention it last, but just because of, if you remember the introduction, I think that's the reason why I will mention that last, is that the environmental benefits of composting that cannot be underestimated. And environmental benefits are, you can quantify environmental benefits in terms of financial and monetary gains, but it would take a long time to make a fail-proof argument in this video. So let's mention that something that it's really easy to understand is that if you don't compost, organic waste will go to landfills. And when you put in a landfill, first of all, the nutrients that is in the waste will go to waste. Nothing will be able to use it. But more important than that, it will generate methane, which is a greenhouse gas that is extremely more powerful than carbon dioxide. So just landfilling organic waste is a really, really, really bad idea. And that's something that is really easy to prevent. And yes, on an environmental scale as well, composting and using compost will regenerate soils. A huge issue that we have throughout the world, not just in Western societies, is that we are depleting our soils by using chemical fertilizers, and it's also having monocrops. But what compost has as a big advantage compared to chemical fertilizers is that it is filled with microorganisms that make the soil live and essentially regenerate the soils. And that's something that is really important, that's going to become extremely more important in the future with global warming, making it even harder for especially small-scale farmers to continue doing what they were doing. Lastly, and that ties back to the concept of self-reliance, is localized economy. If you use and produce resources locally, you cut down on a lot of costs of transportation, for example, and you create an ecosystem, essentially an economic ecosystem, and that's how you can understand it. A localized economy tends to create less pollution because there's less waste in the produce of moving resources around. So that's for the benefits at a macro level. There are drawbacks that you can think of at a micro level that are important to mention in order to be fair in this analysis. And the first one is that it's pretty obvious, but chemical fertilizers, there's an industry for it. Some people are employed in that industry. So if you sort of create an alternate product to chemical fertilizers, some people will lose their jobs. It's a very small fraction of the people, and these people have skills that are transferable and would actually work great for composting. So it's kind of not really a valid point, but it has to be mentioned. And then second one is job loss, and that maybe is not only in the chemical fertilizer industry, but also maybe in waste management, because if individuals are taking the responsibility of composting more, it means that the people who were previously employed in waste management will not have as much business. But that's, again, these people have transferable skills that can apply to composting businesses. And especially if your economy is not, well, if your job market is not at equilibrium, whatever job losses that will happen can be absorbed. And that's something that, again, I do want to mention it as a drawback, so I should not provide a counter argument to it. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the micro aspect of the analysis. So in conclusion, I do want to mention that a lot of the arguments that I provided are hard to quantify. And that's not because there's no data available. It's more because the data is highly variable across different markets. There's a lot of really good data on the US and composting practices in the US. But if you could sort of like do a similar analysis and go in Germany and the UK, even France, you'll find that you won't have similar trends. And in my opinion, it's just because composting, at least large scale initiatives of composting, are very new and we need more research done into it. So that's the academic aspect to it. But in terms of the economic analysis, I believe it's pretty common sense that the benefits outweighs the cost. And that's the most basic way of saying that you should be composting. It is worth it. It is worth your while. And you will see that if you start composting, even whatever you can do at an individual scale, you will notice many benefits to it. So I really encourage people not only to start composting if they haven't done it, but if they're familiar with composting, maybe get organized and find other people that know how to do it. You can create a business out of it. You can talk to your local representative and sort of like see if there's something that can be done in order to alleviate the costs of waste management. And yeah, that's essentially it. That's my conclusion. The benefits of composting outweighs the costs. So that's pretty much it for this video. Again, thank you so much for watching. I realized that it's much longer than I wanted it to be. Maybe I've been rambling on too much. But I would really appreciate any comments and feedbacks in order to improve and sort of like be able to reach more people with this channel. It would also really help if you could like this video. And if you want to subscribe, if I've deserved your subscription, please feel free to do so. I will upload weekly content, mostly on composting, entrepreneurship, and economics, of course. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.